there are misconceptions about social justice, that by saying social justice, we mean that everyone should have the same thing or be the same. And in my mind, it's more, the real focus is on equity and fairness, both in terms of substance and process. What I see as the largest issue is, and there are multiple permutations of it, I would have to say discrimination, but I see it through many different facets of a prism, so I think it takes the form in, you know, either denial or misunderstandings or simply refusal to understand socioeconomic difference, differences in ability, both on an individual level and a group level, to overcome different barriers. There are different ways of addressing healthcare disparities. I think one way or one thing that's really critical is that we adjust our attitudes. You know, there's been such an emphasis over however many years on cultural competence, and unfortunately, I think the way cultural competence training is effectuated sometimes has been to provide people with a laundry list of, you know, this is what this group is, this is what it does. I've been to cultural competence trainings where, you know, part of the training was, can you list 12 sports players from this particular ethnic group? And it's like, and this makes me competent, you know, and the reverse of that is somehow you're culturally incompetent. And I think there's, you know, this expectation that if you go through training, it means that you are able to communicate with everyone of a particular group with a particular attribute, and that's just not the case. So I think, you know, certainly in the medical literature, there's been a movement towards the concepts of cultural humility and cultural safety, the idea that in every interaction, there's something that we don't know or understand, that what it really takes is an awareness that we don't know many things that we need to know. And it really shifts the balance of power in relationships. So instead of a healthcare professional or researcher or public health person going, interacting with an individual or a community or a family as if they are the experts, it's really the other person who's the expert, who holds the knowledge. And the concept of cultural safety, that everyone should be able to feel safe regardless of their identity in whatever context they happen to be in. So, you know, lots of students will ask me, will come and say, I don't know what I want to do. You know, I want to work in social justice, but I don't know what to do. And I think my answer tends to be a little unconventional, because I tell them it has nothing to do with what you want to do. It has to do with who you are and what your values are and how you want to walk through the world and relate to people and manifest your values. And so the real key is finding a discipline that will best allow you to do that at whatever point in life you are. And that vehicle may change over time. And that it's important to find a vehicle that you can be passionate about and invest your energy, because it will take energy and it will take focus. And it doesn't always lead to what people would like to refer to as work-life balance.